I'm Dr. Frita, and today we're going to talk about what sugar does to your body. 7 dangerous side effects of sugar. Now, sugar is sweet, but it can have several sour side effects when it comes to your health. The American Heart Association recommends that women have a maximum of 25 grams of sugar per day, and that men have a maximum of 36 grams. Yet, the average American eats 88 grams of sugar each day. And this can be for many reasons. One, sugar tastes good. Also, sugar causes a stimulation of your pleasure center by causing a high release of dopamine. Also, sugar can give you a quick burst of energy. It can cause a short-term satisfaction when you're feeling hunger pangs. And even if you're trying to cut back on sugars, many people don't realize that some savory foods like breads, tomato sauces, or protein bars, those also can be loaded with added sugars. It's not always obvious. What is clear is that eating excess added sugars can have long-term detrimental effects on your health. So let's talk about it. I'm Dr. Frita, an MD who has been triple board certified, and today we're going to talk about what sugar does to your body. 7 dangerous side effects of sugar. Now, when you think about sugar, there are natural sugars, such as those found in whole vegetables or whole fruits or grains. These aren't the sugars we'll be talking about today, because with the natural sugars, they're also paired with fiber, vitamins, and other nutrients, and they lead to a slow release of energy that we need. The sugars I'm talking about are the added sugars, like the table sugar, which is glucose plus fructose, which makes sucrose, or the high fructose corn syrup, which you'll find on labels of processed foods, or when you're eating things like donuts, ice cream, candies, drinking sodas. These sugars can have the poor side effects on your health. It's important to be a label watcher and to understand what you're watching in those labels, because oftentimes, if you're just looking for the word sugar, or even fructose or corn syrup, you could miss other added sugars like cane syrup or carob syrup or high fructose corn syrup or brown sugar or agave nectar. You have to really be aware to know that just because it doesn't say fructose or sugar, it still could be a form of added sugar. It is recommended that less than 10% of your daily calories come from sugar, but most Americans eat far, far more than that. So let's talk about why we should have a reduced amount of added sugars in our diets. 7 dangerous side effects of sugar. 1, weight gain. When you eat these added sugar calories, the sugar can be converted to fat and you can gain weight. Specifically, you can gain belly fat or get abdominal obesity. And that makes sense. You're eating high calorie foods, high sugars, they turn to fats. But it's actually a little more complex than that, because one thing that happens when you're eating these simple sugars, you have an insulin surge. And when that insulin surges, it causes that sugar to be drawn into your cells. Well, when that happens, you go from having a sugar high to a sugar crash, and you get a reactive hypoglycemia, meaning a reactive low blood sugar, which makes you hungry. So even though you're consuming a lot of calories, you're still hungry for more, which makes you eat more calories and gain weight. Also, when you're dealing with liquid calories, like the high sugars that are in sodas or in very sugary coffee drinks, this will cause you to drink but not be full at all. For example, if you think about a 20-ounce bottle of soda, it can have up to 65 grams of sugar. But it doesn't fill you up. And so you'll drink it, you'll activate that pleasure center, the release of dopamine, which will make you crave more and more sugar. And so you'll be drinking these liquid calories, not getting full, and then still going back and eating more. And this can lead to weight gain. Let's put it in perspective. If you think about a 12 ounce of regular soda, it has about 10 teaspoons or 42 grams of sugar. If you drink 1 12-ounce soda a day without cutting back calories in other places, then over 3 years, you can gain 15 pounds. Excess sugar can lead to weight gain. 2, tooth decay. Sugar feeds bacteria. And so when you eat a lot of sugar and that sugar is stuck to your teeth, the bacteria are able to proliferate and grow. These bacteria then leave excess acid on your teeth. And this acid leads to a weakening of the enamel, which can lead to tooth decay. 3, diabetes. Having a high sugar diet can lead to diabetes mellitus type 2. If you have a diet that is high in blood sugar, 1, it can lead to obesity, specifically abdominal obesity. And if you have abdominal obesity, that can cause a decrease in your insulin sensitivity, meaning that the insulin in your body does not work as well to keep your blood sugar low. Therefore, it can lead to high blood sugar or diabetes. Also, having excess blood sugar can cause your pancreas to ultimately not make enough insulin. Patients with diabetes are also at high risk for living with obesity, high blood pressure, and many other illnesses. 4, eating excess high sugars could ultimately lead to heart disease. When you have a diet that is high in added sugar, it can lead to dyslipidemia or hypercholesterolemia, high cholesterol. It can cause an increase in the bad cholesterol or the LDL and a decrease in the good cholesterol, the HDL. It can also cause a spike in triglycerides. All of this can lead to you having atherosclerosis. This high cholesterol can stick to the inflamed blood vessels, which can cause a blockage of vessels in the heart, leading to heart attacks, or a blockage to blood vessels in the brain, leading to strokes. Be sure to watch my video on the dangers of cholesterol after you finish watching this video. 5, fatty liver disease. Yes, eating a diet high in sugar, high in fruit juices, cakes, and candy can cause the liver to convert the sugar into tiny droplets of fat. This is called non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. And what happens is that these tiny droplets of fat in the liver can lead to inflammation and swelling in the liver. And over time, it can cause scarring and even cirrhosis and liver failure. 6, high blood pressure or hypertension. Yes, can you believe it? Eating a diet high in sugar can lead to high blood pressure. What happens is that when you eat this diet that's high in sugar and you're having excess insulin surges in the body, the insulin can cause blood vessels to be rigid or inflexible, which can lead to hypertension. Also, the high blood sugars can increase your risk for diabetes. Diabetes is the number one cause of kidney disease. Kidney disease can lead to high blood pressure. So there are different pathways. Another thing is just a high blood sugar in and of itself, in some cases, can cause the kidneys to hold on to salt and to water, which leads to high blood pressure. Be sure to download your copy of my book. It's called Under Pressure. It's your step-by-step guide on how to control high blood pressure. This book is packed with valuable tools, guidelines, and information to help you to control high blood pressure. Click the link in the description to get your copy today. 7, mood swings. Diets high in sugar can lead to mood swings because the sugar can interfere with your body's natural production of serotonin. And this can lead to anxiety, to depression, to irritability. There have been several studies that link high sugar intake to anxiety and depression. And in one study in particular, there were about 8,000 participants watched for over 22 years. And one correlation that they found was that in men who ate 66 grams of sugar per day, they had a 23% higher chance of having depression than men who ate 40 grams of sugar or less over a 5-year period. This list is certainly not exhaustive. There are many, many dangerous side effects of sugar. The key is to be a label watcher and make sure you're not tricked by the different names of added sugar and try to reduce the sugar that you eat. If you do have sugar, make sure you brush your teeth right after or rinse your mouth with water in order to avoid tooth decay. Also, try to eat several small meals during the day, small high protein snacks, or if you're eating carbohydrates, make them complex carbohydrates from whole fruits or from whole vegetables, grains. Eating carbohydrates that will be absorbed slowly as opposed to giving you those sugar rushes and the sugar crashes. Be sure to consult with your physician in all things medical that you decide. If you found this video to be helpful and informative, please be sure to like it and to share it with the people you care about. I appreciate you for watching, and I want you to do your best to live your healthiest, happiest life. I'm Dr. Frita.